Yo guys, welcome to Rendrya. My name is Vieku, and today I'm going to be covering another 5 scripts that I use every day in my workflow. Make sure to check previous videos where I was covering other scripts. Anyhow, the first script that it's an absolute must-have in my workflow is PasteRefImage. PasteRefImage is actually a very popular script for pretty much copy and pasting images into Max. So how does it work? You take a screenshot of an image, or you go on, Google right-click copy image, and you can paste it in a form of a plane directly in your Max. So how does it work? I have, for example, this. I need to model this. I know that this is, let's say, 2 centimeters tall. You pretty much select, an area. You take a screenshot. By the way, I'm using Lightshot for screenshots here. So Control C. So go to your Max, locate PasteRef image, open it up, and you pretty much just click PasteRef image, and boom, you got your screenshot here. As you can see, it's pretty much in a form of a plane. Now, a cool thing is, since I mentioned that I, have this object that's 2 centimeters tall, and the plane that was created here is actually 20 centimeters, 20.58 something. Look at this. If you go to reference size fit, you click select reference plane, you click this, and now on the size, just type 2 centimeters, and look at this, start measure, you click and drag from here to here, release your click, and just click again, boom, this is now 2 centimeter. So this thing automatically can resize your images, and that's the amazing thing about it. Cool thing is, if you go to, for example, Google, and you, let's say click this, you can just right click, copy image, go back to Max, and just click PasteRef image, and boom, you got the image here. It's easy as that. Now you can download this script from 3dground.net. It costs $8. Cool thing about it is, you can download the shareware. You can download the script without paying for it, and every time you see this, and every time when you launch it, you're going to get this window which tells you, press number 3, and then you click 3, and then you can use the script. So it's pretty much free. You just have to, press the button when it tells you to press the button. The next script that I'm going to be covering, it's called Batch Merge. Batch Merge is pretty much what the name says. You can grab multiple files at once and merge them into your scene. So this is how it works. Here's the button, Batch Merge. You click on that. You click on Browse. And this is the folder. So on my desktop, of course, this is the folder where I downloaded a bunch of stuff. You see desktop stuff. Okay, so you just click select folder, and it's gonna list all the files that are there. Now you can select which ones you want, or if you want all, and just click the button merge. And after a couple of seconds, you're gonna get all the files merged in your scene, and it's actually just easy as that. You just select the files that you want or a folder, and it just adds everything in. So you can find the script for free at scriptspot.com, and just hit download here, and you can merge stuff. Our next script is Stitch Generator, and Stitch Generator pretty much does what the name says. It generates stitches. So how does it work? You go in your Max, you have your teapot, which needs stitches, obviously, and you start Stitch Generator. And look at this, you go into your edit poly mode, and you just select where you want your stitches to be. Let's say it's this area, and just pretty much hit create stitches. And after a few seconds, you got your stitches. Now you have a lot of these kind of profiles for stitches. Like you can have different types of stitches. So if you select this and this and click create stitches, you're gonna get to see like a thicker stitch. Cool thing is, all of them are loaded, like with normal maps to, pretty much set up materials. They also simulate holes in a form of, like these little planes that they put there. And of course, you can tweak these stitches with all these settings. You can change the length, the width, etc. You can get Stitch Generator at cgsource.com. It costs €29. And yeah, I mean, if you just look at the gallery, these stitches look pretty cool. And yeah, it's turbo fast to do. Our next script or plugin is Randomize Elements. So Randomize Elements pretty much takes like sub-elements of your object, and you can just randomly tilt them, rotate them, etc. So this is how it works. Let's say these are, like glass windows on like a building or something. You can find randomized elements in your modifier list. First thing that you have to do is click on the generate, because it needs to calculate all the objects, and now you just play with the values that you want. So look at this. You can move it like this, or then you can rotate them, you know, like you can add like these slight tilts to the whole thing. But the best part is it's, you know, a button just turn on and off, and it's super cool. That script is free and you can download it from ScriptSpot. You have it randomized elements here, so yeah, make sure to check that out. And our last script is a simple script. It's called remove modifiers. So you got the remove modifiers button here, you press it and you click collect. Now, when you click collect, the script is gonna take your entire scene and it's gonna gather information on all the modifiers that you have applied. So now you can either turn them on, turn them off, or remove modifier. You pretty much select which modifier you want to kind of affect. This is actually very cool because, you know, I used to have scenarios where I would get, you know, an object that has, I don't know, you know, like everything has a turbo smooth on it, and I want to have, you know, just, you know, an instance turbo smooth on everything. Then I would usually manually delete, you know, these turbo smooths until I can unify them all. But with this, you can do that on the fly. I'm gonna, for example, you see, like I have subdivide selected. These two objects have subdivide and they're automatically selected. I click on the turbo smooth, it literally selects all the objects that have turbo smooth, objects that have twist, push. And how does it work? If I go to the turbo smooth one, if I just click turn off, the turbo smooth gets turned off. If I click remove modifiers, it's pretty much just gonna delete turbo smooth from everything. Additionally, when I select my subdivide, I can remove modifier there. Same goes with the, you know, twist. You just select like which one you like. So the twist is actually affecting three objects. You can turn it off and it just globally gets turned off. And that's it for today, guys. Let me know which script have you recently found, and it's kind of a lifesaver for you. And as usual, see you in the next video. Bye.